Hi everyone, here's a walkthrough tour of the upgrades we've done to Damien Gerard's through the lockdown. We're standing out here in the new outdoor area in Murray. G'day Murray. Trusty engineers. Look at this new bench seat, railing. Probably all seen the photos anyway. So we duck inside into the control room. Andrew's in here working away. SSL still going strong. And probably the newest thing in here is this Lynx Aurora. Fantastic interface. Sound very, very good. And also on the wall, actually. What have we got on the wall there, guys?
This is the 1973 wall.
Yeah, okay.
73 Tele Deluxe.
Fantastic.
73 Guild Starfire Base. That's not a 73, but it's lovely 80s custom shop 335. And a 1973 T-Base. That's
beautiful.
Also great.
Beautiful. It's great they're all similar colour too.
70s brown.
Yeah, 70s brown. All right. There's one solitary new hook here too that was left over from the prototypes, which we'll see in a minute, but that's going to be handy. That's how we ended up with all the great new cable hooks, keeping everything neat and tidy. Now there's a couple of new mics. Murray, can you pull out, say, the 67? I'll have a quick squeeze at that. It's an original 1960s Neumann U67 tube mic, the forerunner before the 87 and extremely sought after vintage microphone. So that's a great addition. And then speaking of vintage mics, we've also just last week or the week before, we've got a couple of AKG C414, the original 414s. You can see that classic old looking thing, beautiful. So they, the pair of them are great for overhead and also electric guitar. And moving right along, the drum wall and a lot of the dynamic mics. We've got a keyboard corner now with the Wurlitzer, the Leslie, the Hammond, and that's our MIDI keyboard that plugs into the Pro Tools when we need it to. Karai piano is still going strong. Corner couch is same as. Then we've changed some things over here. This is usually Bass World. There's a Neve preamp there now for that. The projectors are all back online and working great. In-house PA, if anyone needs to do live stuff, still there. And then over here we've got a new spot for the baffles. We've moved the guitar booth. And Murray will do a bit of a reveal here and show us inside. There's double doors. And then that's where we stick the quad box or the combo amp. That isolates it off really, really well. And if you want to also, Murray, come over and just show the loading dock. This is our other spot for anyone that hasn't been in here yet. We use the other side of this loading dock door, which is a big monster of a door to open up. The great thing about this old building being a TV studio early on, a lot of this work was done. So we can use this space in here, not only for loading in the gear, but we can isolate guitar amps in here. So we've got two really good ISO spots for guitars or bass, whatever's needed. Thanks, Murray. And then moving right along into the backline room, we've just picked up this Ludwig Black Beauty snare, which matches with the Ringo kit. It's certainly not as old. The Ringo kit's 62. It's probably more like an 80s Black Beauty. Sounds great though. And then there's constant additions to the amp inventory, and as you saw before, into the guitar inventory as well. So there you have it, guitar room. We're running out of space in here. We've got to find some more space because the guitars just keep on arriving. So yes, oh, we've also finally got some brand, can you pull out one of those brand new 2-inch tapes and open the box? took 6 months to arrive, but since we've got the 2-inch working again, we were still using secondhand tape, but look at that, we've got, finally got some...
It smells good.
...brand new SM900 tape, so there's a few rolls of that ready for sessions. Thanks again, and yeah, hope to see you here soon.